The rescue team are deployed to a man barely alive.
What do you think is the cause of the blown pupil?
Cerebral or some sort. And said some sort of cerebral event, I suspect.
Okay.
A teenage boy's leg has been severely broken. And the team are on high alert as they arrive to a father's worst nightmare.
Benji, open your eyes for me. Benji, I'm going to have a look in your eyes.
As his son drifts in and out of consciousness, in code one.
You guys all secure?
Roger.
In Mission 1, the emergency team are en route to a Status 1 emergency. 73-year-old Don has suffered a possible brain bleed that could take his life. Ambulance ground crews need immediate air support to get Don to hospital fast. He's located 30 minutes flying time southeast of Auckland at Paidoa.
Have indicated that he's a status one. We've now just had an update on the radio to say that the patient's been RSI, which means he's been given drugs to put him to sleep, relax him, paralyze him so they can put a breathing tube down him. He's in a critical condition. He's intubated, which means that we'll take a handover and then take over care from that point until we get to the hospital.
Casco Westpac Rescue 2. I'm landing Pyro, cancel, sir.
Copy, thank you, Westpac Rescue 2.
Tail's coming around to the right.
Roger. Tail clears right of that, clear at that sign.
You can jump out, Aaron, if you want to keep an eye on
okay.
People. Just obviously watch the tail. You guys are clear out too if you want, Rob.
Thank you.
As Rob and Damien arrive at the ambulance, it soon becomes clear that Don is much worse than they expected.
What we got here is a 73-year-old male that these guys performed to today who was extremely combative. Went off his trolley, destroyed the house, so the whole leg fireman holding him down, managed to get a line and gave him 2 milligrams of Nadaz, and that just enough to knock him flat enough to deal with.
Okay.
Now initially he had one blown pupil, but that sort of resolved itself nicely, and then he just went through an RSI procedure.
What do you think is the cause of the blown pupil?
Cerebral or some sort. He's had some sort of cerebral event, I suspect.
Okay.
And apart from that, he's had 200 of sucks to intubate, and he's had 100 of rock, and that's probably how long ago now?
It's 1 o'clock, so half an hour.
Okay.
Yeah, not half an hour.
Yep.
It's difficult for the team to determine the severity of Don's condition on site. The first attending ambulance officer has cleared Don's airway and intubated him ready for the handover. This has already increased his chances of survival.
Are you happy if I start swapping over the monitoring stuff while you're at the head?
Can I just check,
is that a litre enough?
Yes.
Well, litre and a half, perfect. Okay, perfect.
His latest BSL was 7.
Yeah. I've got the tube.
Don is in a bad way.
About 26 at the lips, so that's about 24 at the teeth.
In Mission 2, the response team have been tasked to a teenage boy who may have major injuries after an off-road accident.
So we're responding to a 29 Bravo transportation accident.
Okay.
Come off motorbike and has landed on top of him.
Sure.
16-year-old Jason Smith has rolled his quad bike while at the beach. Reports are that he's suffered a severe fracture to one of his lower limbs and is unable to be moved. He's located at a west coast beach off Port Waikato, 20 minutes flying time south of Auckland.
So responding to Port Waikato to a 16-year-old or a young teenager that's had a motorbike fall on him and apparently got hip, leg and arm injuries. So we've been responded or co-responded with ambulance.
Car park sighted quite a few cars on it.
Yeah.
Fire is clearing an area in the car park.
Good position.
Top of Mandarin 1.
Continue forward slowly.
I think you're clear on the right. It's hard to see, there's a black car.
Better ground.
You're clear on the left.
Hey, Tim. That's us.
Here we are, going.
The team touch down and waste no time tracking down the injured patient.
The head lifeguard's just down here, so okay. You might as well talk to him.
Okay.
The guy the radio on.
What we do need is just to keep people away from the helicopter, yep. If one of your guys is up for that.
Tim, just make sure people stay away from the helicopter. No little kids are here. Ollie.
We've got a doctor here and an ICU nurse.
Great.
Okay. And the nurse are here.
And we got another doctor here.
Great.
So what's actually happened?
He was almost stationary on the quad bike. A motorbike came up off the beach. He tried to avoid it. It hit the side of the quad bike. The bike fell on top of him.
The quad bike or the...
The quad bike fell on top of his left leg.
Okay. So it rolled or...
Can you get the nurse over?
Sure. Okay. And he was on that quad bike?
He was on that quad bike.
Okay.
The motorbike fell on top of my leg.
Yeah, I know.
We'll see. Okay? We'll just get him sorted and stabilised first and then we'll go there. So you're his mum? No allergies to any medicines that you know of? Mum's here too.
Then okay.
Yeah.
Yeah, I know, you're really sore. Can you take a couple of deep breaths in and out for me? Seems to be predominantly leg injuries at this stage. Seems to be fine from here to there, but we're a bit worried about his legs. Obviously, he's not in a great position, so we're going to give him some pain relief and then get him onto our stretcher so we can assess him further.
Oh, it's so sore.
We know.
10 milligrams of morphine, 10 milligrams of the DAS.
Okay.
And 20 mils total.
Okay, understood.
All right.
In Pyrdor, intensive care paramedic Rob Gemmel and Dr. Damien are preparing critically ill patient Don for transport to hospital after he collapsed at home.
Do you think we might be able to tie his hands together? Would you be able to do that with a wee bandage?
It's unclear whether he's suffering from a brain bleed or heart attack. Don's condition is bad.
Now, are you happy if we swap out the Entitle?
Okay.
I've got the tube.
Ambulance crew have intubated Don, which puts the patient into a coma-like state, giving them full control of Don's breathing.
And we've got a baseline pressure of 184. Might be that again, eh? I'll go help organise the stretcher, make sure we're ready to transfer. You happy? Happy, Damien?
Yes.
Okay, mate. So all our monitoring's on. Are we just able to quickly swap that bag out and then we're good to move? If you're happy to move, John?
Oh, when you are, mate. You're cool.
And the only other thing we'd need is just a portable O2 if we can. Oh, it's already connected. There's a strap coming.
One count of three. One, two, three.
Awesome. Hold on. Now we've just got a blanket there for posterity or a sheet. Sheet will do. You can hear.
We are. Good to go.
Yep.
Okay. Yep.
As Don's loaded into the emergency helo, the team run over final checks to ensure the crew arrive without any further complications.
Just confirm we've got a good waveform with his capnography.
We do, yes.
We got a little bit of lacrimation.
Strange. Okay, so he's
probably starting to
light up. Yep.
Or he might need a little bit of sedation.
At Port Waikato, intensive care paramedic Marcel and Dr. Emma are administering vital pain relief to 16-year-old Jason Smith after he was involved in a quad biking accident.
That's really important that you keep your arms still. It's all done, mate. Should we just keep him at a 2 for now until we further assess?
A status 2?
Yeah.
It's unknown the extent of his injuries, so Marcel gives the hospital a heads up.
Marcel here, Catherine. It's a bit windy. We've got one status 2 patient. He's got leg and arm injuries, and we'll manage him and get him off to Middle Moor once we've sorted out. We're just sort of about 100 metres from the surf club near the car park. Okay, thank you. Cheers. Bye. Josh, I'm going to give you some medicine. It might put you in another place, but you'll always be in control and you'll always be safe, okay? You might just feel a bit weird. Just go with it, and it's to look after you, all right? So we can move you in that. I reckon 30. One.
Yeah, I know, buddy.
Two. Three. If you want to have a sleep, that's fine, okay? Okay, we've got a small window. We need to set that up real fast now because he's already disassociated. He's totally out of it. Now we want a couple of strong people. Essentially, if we can get under them on this side, I'll come on this side. Okay, one, okay. Two, three, up.
Good, George.
There you go. Right. Relax, relax. You're doing really well. Just relax. Yeah, that's the way. We all okay? Two, three, up. Got it. Brilliant.
The crew decide Jason needs to be moved to a more stable location before his injuries can be assessed further.
We're just bringing him up here to get him out of the wind. He's just been disassociated a little bit. Yeah, so we'll just come to the back of the machine.
Look, I'm going to have a little look at your leg, so I'm going to have to chop these pants, OK?
It doesn't take Dr. Emma long to identify the source of the injury.
Oh, yep. So it does look like an open femur, Marcel.
Open?
Yeah, I reckon.
Oh, yeah, totally.
So,
excuse me, love. Oh. Keep talking to him, but I just need to get past you there.
If it is a broken femur, he will need immediate treatment.
Sorry, buddy. Sorry, sweetheart. Like I'm so sorry.
Open femur at this stage.
It's going to assist.
Yeah, okay, you got to put a traction on?
I'm not sure. We're just going to check that.
I could put a femoral nerve block in. That would be.
Yeah, we can definitely do that.
In Mission 3, the emergency crew are en route to a young boy injured after he has hit the deck hard. 14-year-old Benji has been thrown from a motorcycle after its back tyre blew out. He's believed to have been a pillion passenger and is now suffering possible head trauma. He has been stabilised by ground crews, 20 minutes flying time north of Auckland in Warkworth. Due to the serious nature of Benji's condition, intensive care paramedic Bruce Kerr and the rest of the emergency team prepare themselves for the worst.
I mean, given he's a motorcyclist, they might have him already packaged.
Yes.
So are you happy to keep turning because we might actually be able to load him reasonably quickly?
Yep, okay.
All right, everyone's going to be good for landing?
Okay.
Yeah, fire, West Bay Rescue 2 on scene now.
That up?
Yeah, got him.
Right, clear on door.
Easy, yep.
They've got trees and they've got the wires along the main State Highway 1.
5 under 4, 3, 2. Holding 1 under. Skid's coming on. Hey, 4 clear out, crew guard.
You're clear, crew guard, yep. Running until advised.
The onboard duty doctor, Tony Smith, heads directly over to the awaiting ambulance.
Should we go inside so we can hear?
Yeah, yeah.
Where he finds that the patient is one of their own.
G'day.
Hey, Tony. So this patient is Phil Sun.
Okay.
He's been the pillion passenger of a motorcycle. The back tire's blown out, and as he's hit the ground, his helmet has come off.
Okay.
He's been unconscious for a period of about 5 minutes prior to our arrival. He has Asperger's and doesn't cope very well to pain.
Right.
Current numbers, he's got a BP at 90 on 50.
Okay.
Prior to the morphine, it was 110 on 70.
Okay. This is Benji, he's 14. He's been on a motorcycle which has been involved in a crash. He's had a period of very abnormal level of consciousness. In other words, he's been knocked out for a while. He's subsequently woken up and been very agitated, and that will be made worse by Benji's Asperger's syndrome. So he's received some pain relief. He's reasonably well settled at the moment. He clearly is badly injured, but not immediately life-threateningly so, and we're going to take him to hospital.
At Port Waikato, intensive care paramedic Marcel and Dr. Emma are assessing the extent of 16-year-old Jason's injuries after he was involved in a quad biking accident.
I reckon we give him another 20, okay?
That sounds a great idea. Here it is here.
Due to the severe pain caused by his injury, Dr. Emma will need to administer further pain relief before transport.
Because we're going to transport you and you might be shaking around a bit, I'm going to numb up the nerve in your leg. Okay, it sounds a bit weird. It'll be a little injection into your groin. It'll be as quick as I can be, okay?
Nema's going to put a bit of anaesthetic around the nerve so that he can't feel it further down his leg because it's so sore and it possibly is broken underneath in his femur.
Okay, little needle in your groin coming up, bud. Good one.
Just breathe slowly. Breathe slowly. Breathe slowly. That's the way.
Really well.
So what have you got there?
Ripivacaine, 75
oh,
mgs,
brilliant.
So it's about 1 per kilo. And I've diluted it down with a bit of saline as well.
Great.
Done.
Brilliant. I'll do that.
Thank you.
So your leg numbing's all done, mate. You just relax. You're doing fantastic.
just popped in what we call a femoral nerve block. It's to just numb up the nerves in his leg in case he's got a broken femur there. So we're going to Auckland Hospital, where the trauma team will meet him and do a full assessment.
On three. One, two, three. That's it. Yep, in. Perfect. Well done. You can let go now. That's awesome. Thanks for your help, dude.
Jason's mother will also travel on the 35-minute flight to hospital, where doctors are waiting for his arrival. Benji is now ready to be transported to hospital after he was involved in a motorcycle accident.
Benji, open your eyes for me. Benji, gonna have a look in your eyes.
4 milligrams of morphine.
Morphine, yeah. Right. And the rest is just. Yeah.
Benji, squeeze my fingers with your left hand, Benji. Squeeze my fingers.
4 milligrams, 10 milligrams.
Okay. We clearly obviously need to take him off to hospital. Now, do you want to try and come with us?
I'd like to, yeah.
Yeah, okay. Now, I think in the meantime, we'll bring our stretcher up. We'll bring him out, we'll pop him onto our stretcher, and I think we'll get rid of the scoop. Are you happy with that?
Dr. Tony Smith has identified that Benji needs immediate hospital care to determine the full extent of his internal head injury.
Can I clarify, the morphine is 1 per mil?
Yes.
I think we could go to the helicopter without the oxygen.
Final preparations are made as crewman Artie Wynyard makes final adjustments.
Yeah, they've got the heading.
Hopefully, the fast turnaround gets Benji to hospital in time to get the much-needed medical treatment he so desperately needs.
Okay, coming up over the fence, stretching right, nose right, tail left, couple left.
73-year-old Don is about to be transported to hospital after collapsing at home. He is in a critical condition that could end badly.
So drugs are going to be by Doc.
Got it.
I've got airway.
Perfect.
The intubation roll is beside me and my bougie was right here in case we need to re-intubate, but I don't really want to do that in flight. I'd rather just manage with a superglottic if it all goes to pot.
It's still unclear if it was a heart attack or brain bleed, although both are life-threatening.
I'm going to give him, depending on his blood pressure, most likely 2 midazolam and about 40 of ketamine to keep him under.
Okay.
Once he starts fighting the rest, the radar will give him another 50 of rock.
Okay. You happy to start?
I am.
Okay. Good for a start, Paulie, when you are.
Thanks,
Rob. Good to have you there in less than 20 minutes from now.
Roger.
You guys all good to make for liftoff?
Okay, we are. 1, 2, 3, 4, secure. Coming up.
Okay.
Good afternoon, Waikato, Westpac 2. How do you read?
Roger, call. Sign over.
Roger, a male as a result of a cerebral event. He was initially combative and agitated. He's been RSI'd at the scene. He's currently status 1, intubated, ventilated, has a systolic pressure of about 80, a heart rate of 100. As I said, status 1 with you in about 5 minutes over.
Thank you. I'll inform the attendants and we'll be expecting
you.
Hospital out.
Couple thanks.
Guys, good the bag for landing?
We are. Thanks, mate. All four secure.
All secure, bro.
Happy, Damien?
Yep. Doing good.
We got you.
We assume that he's had some sort of stroke, but again, you know, that's really only speculation, and it would be more for the hospital to do a barrage of tests, you know, whether it be an MRI, to determine what's actually going on in his brain. But the way that he presented definitely sounded like there was something going on in his brain that was contributing to this.
Yeah. Looks good, good, good.
At this point, we don't really know what caused the cerebral event. He is now being prepared to go into the CT scanner, and hopefully that will give us some answers.
After multiple scans, Don was diagnosed to have had a severe seizure that caused him to collapse. Don has a history of heart attacks and multiple problems involving seizure activity. Fortunately, he's still here to tell his tale of what happened that terrible day, back in his hometown of Paidoa with his partner Elaine.
Coming home, I knew something was wrong with his arm. Sat down in the chair, said, Elaine, I'm not right. That's the last I remember at that stage.
And that's when partner Elaine read the signs and wasted no time to signal the alarm.
When he walked through the back door, I knew immediately what was going on. And then when I hit the alarm and I started to talk to the people that talked to you about whatever was going on, immediately I said, get the helicopter, we're members, which I'm so grateful for, because we only joined because of, you know, what was happening to Don in the past. And I thought we made a good decision there. And then the helicopter come, and that's the story.
It's a part of the story Don will never be able to remember. And it's times like these, Don focuses on the more important things in life.
A father of five children. I live well north of them, from Palmerston to Tamanui. I should see more of them. When I woke up in hospital, they were there. They've always been to assist with me at hospital. I'm very lucky to have a family. I'm very proud of them.
Don is most grateful to all the services that gave him another chance.
I'm alive and kicking, and just thank you very much to those guys. If it wasn't for them, I wouldn't be here talking to you like this.
16-year-old Jason was diagnosed with a hematoma to his right leg and was released later that evening. Benji spent 2 days in hospital. He was cleared of any brain trauma but suffered a major concussion. He's back to his old self after being released from hospital. And Elaine's just happy to have her partner by her side.
I'm glad to have my husband still with me. Oh, he's my partner of 22 years.
Should they have been that long?
Yes, you lucky devil.